Dr. Hari Teja again. So today in our session of civilsgk.com, we will able to find out the union budget of 2016 and 17. What are the important things of this budget, and from this scenario how the budget are going to come into picture also. So if you like the idea, the concept of civilsgk.com, please like, share and even subscribe also, so that whenever I put the new video, it tells you about which video comes into picture, what is the description, it how to do it, you understand the point. And after this video, please try to find, write at least 20 questions that will be there in civilsgk.com website. You can practice those questions also after finishing this video. So my idea or my view is, when you're done with this topic, when you're done with the objective also, it has been done, you know it, the topic, that is what. So now let us start the union budget of 2016-17 of Indian government. Normally the under the first slide, we are going to learn how the budget making process. I'll make it very very short so that it will be understand by you, right? So actually the budget making process starts in September actually. So finance minister holds a pre-budget meetings with all kind of other ministries and secretaries also, what is their proposals and each and everything, how they wanted money, why they wanted money. So each and every, in a descriptive manner, the finance minister will hold. Under this pre-budget meeting, every ministry secretary will come and tell, this is the requirement for the next year, that we wanted this much of money. Why we wanted this much of money also have to be described with the secretary or the concerned ministry. Right, and the finance minister will take a final call on the tax proposals. When after this has been done, then the government will suggest a date to the finance minister, that this is on the this particular date we have done with the document, and we have to present this document in the parliament. Right, so when this has been done, then the government takes a president approval, and the finance minister present the budget in parliament. So budget is a word which you can't able to find out in entire Indian constitution. It will be, budget is a word which came from French, which is mean by a bogoti. Bogoti mean to say leather bag. So you can able to find out the leather bag equal over here in the image by handling by the Arun Jaitley. So this kind of bag actually you will be called as a bagat. So in on a period of time in India slum or in English language, it has been transferred as a budget. In India, budget is a word which has not existed in the constitution. But then what if the budget can be called in Indian constitution? By article 112, you call it as an annual financial statement. What is this annual financial statement? Try to analyze it. Annual, so year ending, financial statement, a statement which gives or which tells about what is the India's condition. So the budget which tells you that what is the condition of India, what is the amount that the Indian government had, how much the debt they had, how much they are spending to other things. So that entire thing you call it as a budget. Budget is a word which is not exist in Indian constitution. It can be called by another name called annual financial statement, AFS. So we will learn more and more things related to the budget and budget topics in detailed scenario of economic scenario, economic survey. You got to understand, after this budget, the next session that I'm going to upload in the budget, this thing, which is nothing but economic survey, in that we will clearly learn about those things. Clear? Next. So February 29, 2016, the Union Minister, Union Finance Minister Arun Jaitley, the Finance Minister of India, presented the general budget in Lok Sabha for the year of 2016 and 17. Right? Right. So his idea mostly targeted 9 pillars. So first kind of situation, that Indian government segregated all the things into a very peculiar form each and everyone can able to understand. Before, the budget was being presented by most of the governments, but it was so clumsy to understand. But this budget, the Arun Jaitley made himself and stated very clearly that we are targeting 9 pillars of Indian government. The 9 pillars are as follows. What is the use of 9 pillars actually? Transform the large country into development and growth. Don't worry with the words of development and growth. We will find much more detailed way aspects of development and growth in economic survey. So the 9 pillars are agriculture and family welfare, one and the same, right? Then rural sector. Then afterwards, social sector and health care will be one. Education, skill, job creation, infrastructure, investment, right? financial sector reforms, governance reforms, and ease of doing business. See, the main problem that the Indian government will have is that they'll have so much of trouble if a other company which comes into India, they will have so much a problem in doing a business in India because of the red tapeism, or otherwise you can say yellow work, whatever the name that you wanted to give. So the doing a business in India is very tough. So making the business in India very easy, and physical discipline and tax reform to reduce compliance burden also. This is the issue. These 9 pillars we will study in detail, how much the amount that they put for each and every pillar, and what are the schemes which came through this budget, how much that they have given each and everything in detail. I'll make it so simple, don't worry. The concepts like investment, or you say physical discipline, all that things will be explained in economic survey. Wait for the next video, you will clear with the concepts. Here I am just explaining what are the new schemes which came into picture, what is budget agenda, that's it. Clear? Now, under agriculture and family welfare, what the Indian government presented, these points are very, very important. So please take it up, right? Please take a note and write with a pen. These points are very, very important. Allocated for agriculture and family welfare almost 35,984 crores. Normally this amount is not useful for you who is preparing for UPSC, but those who are preparing for SSC, or those who are preparing for bank, those who are preparing for any other government examination or any other public state service commission, then this point is very, very important, right? Right. So now, the other thing is, we already done with most of the projects we used to go with, or we had put most of the money on irrigations, right? Under irrigation, there is one more program which has existed, which is nothing but Pradhan Mantri Krishi Sinchai Yojana. So this project is going to be launched on a mission mode, and this missions are almost 6 in number, 6 mission they have taken that. And 6 missions will cover almost 28 lakh hectare will be bought under irrigation. So you can able to understand, when these under this project, most of the amount of 35,984 crores, most of that, almost like somewhere around 42% of the amount has been spent on irrigation itself. When you are spending more number in irrigation itself, what will happen? It makes you to get 28.25 lakh hectares coming under irrigation. Very, very important. What is the scheme for that? It is an MCQ. Please make a point. It's an MCQ. Government has already decided to have a long-term irrigation fund for irrigation. Every time the government could not able to take funding every time, right? So it is easy for the government to make it very simple in a different way, right? So what is the thing that they wanted to do? They wanted to have a long-term irrigation fund within NABARD itself. You understand my point? With an initial corpus of 20,000 crore. So once the NABARD has got this 20,000 crore rupees, and NABARD is going to spend on irrigation from the next year budget itself. You got my point? If any irrigation project which has got the national status, like in AP, you can able to find out recent national status of irrigation project or a dam which has been given for that is Polavaram project, right? So those kind of projects itself, the government will able to put money, right? Rest of all, from the next year onwards, the irrigations will be, the amount for irrigation will be available from the long-term irrigation fund itself, that will be within NABARD. So the corpus fund is almost 20,000 crores, which was very important for you. Right. MNGRA is a one program which is a Brazilian economist, and it was launched by the UPA government, and it is very major hit, right? So, and we need to produce more number of we have to support the common people or the below poverty line under MNGRA program, and the program is a major hit, so most of the people will get attracted to it itself. For that, the central government 5 lakh farm ponds and dug wells in rain-fed areas, and 10 lakh composite pits also for production of organic manure has to be done by the MNGRA workers. Those who already got registered and those who are already working with MNGRA. So the 5 lakh farm ponds and dug wells and 10 lakh composite pits will be given to MNGRA scheme. So for that, what about the cost of the money will be given to them itself? They will do the thing required for the Indian government. Clear? Soil health card scheme. I think you already come across what is meant by soil health card scheme. To make it more simple, the health of the soil will be known easily, and after every 3 years you can go to the lab again with the soil, and you will able to know what is the composite or what is the composition that you need to flow over on the land. So that is nothing but soil health card scheme, and this is going to give 14 crore farm holdings by March 2017. This is an objective that they did, and in the next year budget we will see how much they have given. Clear? And 2000 model retail outlets also will become under fertilizer companies, and which will provide soil and seed testing facilities also during next 3 years. Promote organic farming through Parampagat Krishi Vikas Yojana. It is a scheme which launched only for organic farming itself. So this organic farming is doing better. You can able to find out the first state in India who transferred themselves into first organic state is nothing but Sikkim. In this, after completing this budget session, I will upload the Sikkim organic plantation, or Sikkim how it became into a first organic state. So in agriculture, this topic is very, very important for you, because agriculture for under prelims you will able to get more marks, and at the same time in mains also, in geography, and at the same time you will have in GS paper 3 also, right? But this organic value chain was not able to do much progress in northeast area. So for concentrating the northeast area, the organic value chain will implement in northeast region also. Unified agriculture marketing is just a small thing which is already came in the last year's budget, and the same thing which came into picture, which is nothing but any person can do marketing by getting into a e-platform agriculture marketing for wholesale markets also. That is what. Clear? And again, under agriculture and family welfare, you just look into the pictures, right? Allocation under Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana was increased to 19,000 crore. You can able to understand India can be clubbed by national highways. This national highway project was launched by Dr. Atal Bihari Vajpayee, the former Prime Minister of India, right? That person who connected the India by national highways, and state highways also came by that era itself. So there is an NHAI project and SHAI project also existed, who looks take care or who takes care about the NHAI, right? That's we already done. But what is this Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana? There is a north-south corridor, and there is a north-south corridor and east-west corridor, and there is a golden quadrilateral also. Golden quadrilateral will be this way. So Jammu Kashmir to Kanyakumari, from Porbandar to Silchar in Arunachal Pradesh, and four major metropolitan cities will get connected by this golden quadrilateral. And beside this you will have NH, and beside this you will have SH, state highways. This is the concept that we had for connecting tier 2 and tier 3 cities. Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana came into picture. For that 19,000 crores was being given it. Got to understand my point. So Prime Minister Fasal Bima Yojana, 5,500 crores came into picture, and 850 crores government spent this year for National Genomic Center for Indigenous Breed. Four National Genomic Centers are going to come into picture. One is in Hyderabad, Bhuneshwar, and some other two places. So that places have not been nominated till so far. Only Hyderabad and Bhuneshwar are nominated. So National Genomic Centers are going to come into picture. And for these four National Genomic Centers, 850 crores. What is the use of National Genomic Center? For indigenous bread, which will be helpful for us. And now we'll see for the rural sector what Indian government did, or the what the budget tells to us. Under rural sector, 87,765 crore was allocated. Under 14th commission clearly said, very clearly, it is a recommendation under 14th commission that 2.8 lakh crore have to give as a grant in aid for gram panchayats and municipalities for their development, and make them as an independent body for decentralization or more democratic situations. So this is a recommendation which has been given. That recommendation is implemented. So very, very clear. So you can get a connectivity that Finance Commission, what is the use of Finance Commission? You can say Finance Commission is an advisory body. That advisory is very good by sensing of democracy. So that democracy values was being attributed and attained by Indian government. So that is the reason Indian government give a budget of almost 2.87 lakh crore for Gram Panchayatis and municipalities for making them efficient and more decentralization and more independent. Understood? Right. For some other works under rural sector, 38,500 crores was allocated for MNGRA, and this is one more thing. Every block under drought and rural distress. See, block mean to say two or one district will be clubbed together, called as a block. This block definition, if you wanted to get into picture, you need to see the community development program which started in 1952. Okay, we will discuss all these things, but to the part you just need this much itself, right? Block mean to say two or three districts will be called will one block. So now most of the blocks will be under drought and rural distress. So intensive block to develop, there is a scheme which called as a Deen Dayal Antyodaya Mission. Right, next. Rural sector. 300 rural sector clusters will be developed under the Shyam Prasad Mukherjee Rural Urban Mission, right? 100% village electrification, 100% rural electrification by 1st May 2018 going to come into picture. And priority allocation forms, central sponsored, more free from open defection. Very, very important to you. Clear? So the first, again, open defection, fully toiletized state is nothing but again Sikkim. Right. And next, for social and health sector, what is the budget tells you? This is mostly about a scheme what we are discussing about. Clear? Almost this is the amount, 151,581 crore, which includes both the social sector, education and health sector also. 2000 crores was allocated for initial cost of providing LPG connections to BPL families. So there is no wood that can be used by BPL families, so there is no smoke or no health pollution going to come into picture. So it would be most better, and you can able to understand that when BPL families are getting the LPG connections, it is better for them itself, right? And a new health protection scheme which was launched by the central government, it is that 1 lakh per family will be given, and for senior citizen it is an additional top up of 30,000 rupees also will be given, right? The scheme is not named as of now. And 3,000 stores of Prime Minister Janna Ashuddha Yojana will be opened during 16 and 17. National Dialysis Service Program also launched under PPP program. So anyone who wanted to get interested with this scenario, they can apply and they can able to do it. Clear? Next. Social sector again. There is a new scheme which came into picture, which is nothing but Stand Up India. The scheme, nothing. There are more number of banks that existed in India, right? So each and every bank has to finance at least two projects per bank per branch. You got my point? So this will benefit at least 2.5 lakh entrepreneurs. So it is a very good scheme, Stand Up India, like Make in India, Skill in India. So Stand Up India. So by this scheme, every bank has to finance at least two projects they have to get finished, right? Very important one for you all of people. So later the details of Stand Up will come into picture, then we will discuss. National Scheduled Cash Partnership also with comes into picture of associations. See, scheduled, National Scheduled Cash Partnerships. See, simply, when you wanted to get the cash to, should be transferred to most number of industries, it will be tough. So there will be an industry association will be associated, and it makes it easy to transfer the cashes, right? So on the birth century of Pandit Deen Dayal, 100 crores was allocated to his scenario for labors, works and each and everything. Upadhyaya is another scheme which Deen Dayal Upadhyaya. So on the 350th birth of anniversary of Guru Gobind Singh and Pandit Deen Dayal, 100 crores was allocated for the health sector. Now we're looking into education, skill and job creation. Under this, what Indian government did for education, or skill or job creation, you required basic education has been required. So for basic education, government started 62 Navovidyalayas was going to be started this year, and government will establish a higher education financing agency with a corpus of 1,000 crores. This corpus is very, very important to you for those who are writing some kind of NABARD exam, something like that. And one more thing, there is already one more corpus fund which has already came in the first of agriculture that you can able to find out. That is also important for this thing. And in a digital depository will come into picture as like as a digital India, the same like leaving certificate, college degree, academic certificates, mark sheets, all will you can take it as an E, and you can able to there will be some kind of MB which will be given to you or a GB will be given to you, so that you can show them very clearly your certificates and all. So if you are going to any other job from now onward, there is no need to show all these kind of certificates in person other than that when you joined. Clear? Again, for the same concept of education, job and skill, 804 crore has been given to the Indian government for skill development, and 1500 multi-skill ITI training institutions are going to come into picture, and the government will establish National Board of Skill Development partnership with most of the industries. What, see, there are more and more companies are going to come into picture. Private sector is more efficient than always with the government sector. Private sector will try to increase their missions and missionaries with a very hot face. When they are making their things in a very fast way, government also do it. But the government ITI and each and everything is not sufficient, well equipped with things. So that is the reason. What is the present scenario requirements will be understood by the National Board of Skill Development, and they will give certifications according to the scenario itself. And the government will provide entrepreneurship education and training through online courses itself. It helps most of the people can't able to go to any other places. For infrastructure and investment, what government did? Right? 97,000 crore during 2016 and 17. Why this much? Because in the year of 2016 and 17, we wanted to have 10,000 kilometers highway we wanted to lay it. So that is the reason we have given this much. And an allocation of 55,000 crore for roads, an additional 15,000 crore raised by NHA through bonds. So NHA has got almost they have got 15,000. So additionally they have got 97,000. So to lay down the 10,000 kilometers of highway. And what is the thing that they have did in financial sector reforms? A comprehensive code of resolution of financial firms was introduced, and a law-based monetary policy also is going to come into picture through a finance bill, as like as finance bill how it to come into picture. So the law-based or a framework is going to come into picture, and a financial data management center is going to set up. So each and everything that goes into country will be understood by getting a simple click on computer. And RBI will facilitate the government securities in retail participation. So retail companies can able to participate in government securities also, that made easy by RBI from now onwards. And new derivative products will be launched by SEBI, and some amendments in Sarafasi Act 2002. Almost 12 amendments are going to come into Sarafasi Act. So don't be worried what is the Sarafasi, what is this derivatives and all. We'll just be done in economic in a clear manner. Clear?
Right.
And increasing the number of benches in SAT Security Ability Tribunal, and allocation of almost 25,000 crore for public sector banks also. Right? So there is Pradhan Mantri Mudra Yojana scheme is existed. This scheme amount was increased almost to 1,80,000 crores. So for doing ease of business, Aadhaar was going to give a statutory backupping. Aadhaar is going to have a law. So till now Aadhaar don't have a law. Aadhaar is going to get some kind of a law. So Aadhaar is making compulsory to each and every person. And to get the fair share process, or you can say in a simple words, the ration shops, you have to apply, and your application will be scrutinized by more number of people, and then by letter you will able to get each and everything to your home. Right now that is going to be simplified by automation facility by March 2017, so it will be helpful for you. And a task force will comes into picture to do the work in an easy, and it will consult to most of the ministries. So one ministry had one problem. See, let us say I am supporting, or I am making a company that comes into India, or I'm setting up a company in India. But to set up a company in India, you required almost 22 directorates and 12 ministry signature are required. So the thing is going to be slacked down, or my file is going to be stuck down on one of the bench of the officer. Now what should I have to do? So my work will be done by a task force, and they will consult with, they will look after the each and everything. They do the things very easy. That's nothing but the company's office. And the Companies Act will be amended to have an enabling environment for startups. And 900 crores is maintain stable prices of Pulse, to maintain the Pulse's prices, because Pulses are the one who created the inflation for oil and each and everything. So Pulses are one of the kind of process of creating inflation, right? So for making them to stabilize, the price stabilization fund is also been created for 900 crore to maintain the stable price of Pulses. And Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat program will be launched to link all kind of districts and state, something kind of a spiritualism or language or trade and cultural tourism or cultural travel will be done in all these kind of this thing. So you can understand by this project, the government wanted to make a unification. So that kind of project, you call it as Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat. Very, very important. To make it show short notes, what till so far what we have done, or what is this all about? I'm just making a slide note so that you can able to understand so simple what actually things are, right? Till so far we have covered what is the budget and all, and what we are going to discuss, how many schemes which came into picture under each and every things, right? So under this scenario we will discuss that what till so far what happened. I'm just giving us a simple way to make you to understand. You got my point? So under the first of it, we will have National Investment Grid. What is this National Investment Grid is all about? National Investment Grid to promote the private investment in different areas. The Department of Industrial Policy has initiated National Investment Grid, which will create a business opportunities in different states so that the private sector will be encouraged to participate. That is what for National Investment Grid. And there is a simplification of income tax also. Now income tax is so clumsy, every year the budget the tax slab will comes into picture to make the slab rate at once, or by using some other concepts. There are so many problems with IT Act also. To make it so simplified to understand each and every common people, or you can take the alternative documents like PAN card, higher, simply for a non-resident India who comes to India to provide these kind of documents, it's very trouble. To making so simplified, Justice Issuer Committee was launched, and we already discussed under financial reform SAT number is going to be more, and we already told that derivatives will be added to Indian government by SEBI. And for roads and projects, this is short notes, or you can say the recap of the lesson that we have told till so far. Big projects and powers are going to come into picture. So, and you can able to find out this ultra mega power project that we had. Ultra mega power projects. Right? This projects are very, very big, and they can able to produce more number of current. So for that 1.5 lakh crore in the current and next fiscal year also that they will produce. So that is what the first thing. And coal cess doubled. The clean energy cess on coal, now called as an environment, a clean environment tax, has been now doubled 400 per ton. Very, very important. 400 per ton. 400 per ton it has been increased. Now you need to understand that scenario. Right. This will rise the price of power by 20 paisa per unit, and which will be passed on consumers, and something you can able to understand, your current price might increase also. And we already done the amendments to make the startup comes into picture, or to provide the enabling environment for startups. There will be amendments are going to come into picture, and there is one more amendment, Sarafasi Act also. And more number of startup companies are going to come into picture. So that is the reason tax breaks for newbies, or tax free for newbies also for first 5 years. And for women, students and Dalit, it's something like the government allocate almost 500 crores to establish a startup hub for women and aspiring entrepreneurs. So it is something like free for them. I'll give you those things in a bit format, and there I will explain. And you can able to find out that new bonds are going to come into picture, more number of bonds are going to come into picture, because RBI is making the government securities to come for more number of retail wholesale participation also. So these bonds will tie you as a bondage also. We will see. So service tax relief for patients. So those those who are patients, even in hospital also, there will be a, some kind of service tax are going to come into picture. So there will be a service, insurance provider under Nirmaya Health Insurance Scheme launched by National Trust for Welfare of Celibacy or you call Celibacy Plasty or Mental Retardation, Multiple Disabilities. So you will be exempted that 14%. Right, so it will be better. And even the budget also proposal to remove the custom duty for braille paper from 10% at present as of now. That is a 10% on braille paper also, that is going to be removed, right? And expected revenue from spectrum, government estimate revenue was almost a higher amount, which is almost 1 lakh crore, by auctioning the spectrum license and one-time spectrum charges in the year ending of March 2017. So that is going to come in the next year, and it will be helpful for more development in India next year. You can able to find out, and you can able to find out there is a subsidy bill also, right? Government has budget total subsidies of 2.5 lakh crore for the financial year 17, and lower than the revised estimate. So this are small things, nothing more about this thing. And Aadhaar, I told you Aadhaar is going to get a statutory backing, which is nothing but single platform for social delivery, right? So even now, health protection plan providing 1 lakh per family, and above 30 years, above 60 years, there will be a top up also. That is also going to come under this itself. So each and everything is getting connected with Aadhaar. So single platform for entire social delivery in India. And no more route to be burned. So almost 2000 crores was being initiated by Indian government for the BPL LPG connections. So no more route to be constructed. This is what the entire session of budget actually. So it's as so simple we done with as of now, right? So if you like the concept, find the bits of union budget. You can able to find the bits on union budget in civilgk.com. 20 bits are going to come into picture. Please practice it. When you practice more and more, you will able to done easily. So if you like the idea, thank you. Please share, link, like, subscribe. Regards, Dr. Hari Teja. Thank you very much. Right? Thank you very much, Lord.